Hey guys, I'm Kurt with Off-Road Armor, and today we're going to be putting some Rival half doors on this Can-Am Defender here. And if you want to come back here and take a look, these are the doors. They are steel skin doors, and they are a 1-inch tubed frame on there, and they are powder coated. And they've even come with a real nice pad right here for you to rest your arm on. So this is the first time seeing one of these. And they look really solid. I mean, they've got looks like a nice latch right there, easy to open latch. And as you can see, there's the inside of it. So we're gonna go ahead, get this installed. I'll go through the instructions and we can see how they go on. All right, so I first wanted to mention how nice these doors were boxed up and packaged in here. I mean, plenty of wrapping on it, and you know, in the appropriate size box. So that's a good start, because some manufacturers don't seem to wrap their products very good, and you get a lot of stuff that comes in damaged. So we're gonna go ahead and take all this stuff apart and find the instructions, and we'll let you know how that goes. All right, so I got out the instructions here, and it's good. I don't know how to read anyways, so I mean, it's got some English and a couple other languages there, but pictures, so that's good. We got some good pictures here, so we can figure out how to do this. And all our brackets, looks like we've got some washers there. Some spacers and bolts there. We should be good to go here. We got everything. We've got the brackets, the hinges, I guess. And now I wanted to let you guys know this Rival is based out of Russia. And for you guys that know the off-road industry, a lot of Russia's products are very solidly built. But Rival does have a distributor in Texas, and then obviously we do sell these online at offroadarmor.com. So we're gonna go ahead, we'll get started, and let's see how long it takes. We're probably just gonna do the driver's door, just the driver's door, so you get a good idea. But we'll go ahead and get started on that and go through the motions. All right, so I wanted to go over the first thing. We've taken this off the front part of the door there, and then we've taken this bar off. So it's pretty simple. Just got two screws right there, and then you've got to take both of the screws off there, and then the two bolts that are down there. So you're just gonna take this bar off, and we'll go ahead and move on to installing this bracket right here. All right, so I'm putting this bracket on, as you can see here. I realized that you kind of need to tilt the bed up to get to these positions. So now that I've got everything on the back, I can't really tilt it. So you guys might want to put your stuff on the ground instead of on the back of the bed like I did. But let me see if I can turn this around and let you see here. So there's the, let's see, how do I? So there's the holes right there. Would be nice if I could tilt the bed up, but anyways, you're gonna just put this bracket like this, right in there. And we'll see if I can do that without having to take everything off the bed, but yeah, let's give that a shot. So unfortunately, I wasn't able to get the bolts in without having to take everything off the bed. So I'll learn from my mistake, don't put anything on the bed, because you're gonna need to raise this up. And now that I've got the bed raised, I can get to these bolts here. Okay, so if you're anything like me, kind of unorganized, so if the pages aren't stapled together, I lose which page I'm on, so good thing they're numbered. So I've got page 4. All right, so we're on page 5 here, and looks like we're going to be putting on that bar there. So I got the bars over here. We're going to be putting one of these on, so we'll go ahead and give that a shot. All right, so this little picture here is just talking about how we're going to take these bolts off I'm sorry, these nuts. And that's how that's gonna attach to those right there. So we'll go ahead and get that done and see how that turns out. So another thing I just realized that I would suggest to everybody while putting these doors on is, well, you're really not gonna need the net anymore, and it kind of just gets in the way. So that might be one of the first steps you might wanna do, is take that darn net off there. Yeah, it's because it's just a pain. But looks like we're gonna be putting obviously that right there, and then this bottom is gonna go in behind there. So we'll see how that turns out. Okay, so I figured I'd try to go ahead and get the net off, and unfortunately, yeah, it should be. I got my dad here helping me out. He's getting ready to light this thing up because, unfortunately, this is kind of rounding off in here. K&M likes to use some screw tightener, and so it rounded off a little bit in there. So we're gonna go ahead and heat it up, try to get it out. Now you're gonna need these Torx. So if you don't have any of these, you're gonna need to get some of these before you start this project. So I'm using a 27 here. Hopefully we can get this off. Okay, so here's something the manufacturers don't say in the instructions, is that when you're mounting this bracket on right here, you gotta do some cutting to your inside of your plastic here, on the inside of your doorway. So I'm gonna show you guys real quick here. So I've had to cut that out right there to allow room for that to sit flush, for this bracket right here to sit flush on there. So what I did was, it ain't the prettiest. I think I could have done a little bit better of a job cutting it, but you know, you're really not gonna see that anyways. But so what I did was I just took a box cutter knife. I heated the end up with a lighter. So I got it hot, and then it kind of melts into the plastic a little bit, and it cuts a lot easier. So just a trick of the trade. But so we're gonna go ahead. Now it should give us enough room to put the bar on right here. Let's just go ahead and see if I can do this while we're chatting. So that's gonna go right there, and then, so you're constantly going to be fighting the seatbelt. That's just something you're just going to have to deal with when you're doing this. But we'll go ahead and get that bolted on there and see how it looks. Okay, so I've got the bar on. That's going to hold the hinge for the door there. And I've got it. So you're going to place it in there. I don't have it bolted in quite yet, but you're going to place it in there. And then you're gonna go ahead and, like I said, you gotta cut this plastic off here, and then this just slides into, you'll loosen these up. You don't have to take them all the way off, but you'll loosen these up, and you'll just slide these on in there, because it's they're like grooves, so you can do that, and you'll just tighten them. And so we've completed step four there. Well, I gotta put the bolts in still, but anyways, we'll be now we'll be focusing on putting this bracket on. When putting these top bolts in on here, I'm gonna suggest using the original bolts from the machine, because you're gonna need the washer, the spacer there. So go ahead and we'll put these on. But like I said, just reuse the original bolts. So like I said before, we're gonna put this bracket on, which I've done here. It's just two bolts right there. So I've kept this loose. I always recommend keeping a lot of your stuff a little bit loose, just because it might just need a little bit of tweaking, especially on doors. So I've gone ahead and kind of went a few steps ahead here to get this done. But so this bracket that we put on earlier is going to attach right here. So you're going to end up putting these two bolts in here, and Obviously, they got welded on nuts from the backside, so you're going to just attach that there. Again, keep those loose because you might need to adjust them. And so we've gone ahead and put this door on. So we put the door in the hinges. So easy enough, you just slide them on in there. And then you're going to go ahead and this part right here, which keeps the door from just flying wide open. It stops right there. You're going to go ahead and put this bolt in here and fasten that. Go ahead and you've got these two bolts here. Again, keep those a little loose because you never know what kind of adjustments that you're going to need to do. And again, like I said, I've gone a few steps ahead here. So I went ahead and put the striker bolt on with this bracket. So these holes are already in the machine and you just slide this bracket on in there. Easy enough. Use the original hardware. So there's two bolts that you had left over from taking off something earlier that I reused on here. I always try to use the original bolts if I can. You know those are a little bit heavier duty of bolts. And then again, you go ahead, there was already holes right there, so we put those back in. Those are original bolts as well, screws. So, and then you put the striker pin on. This easy adjustment, you just got these two bolts here, easy adjustment. So really that was all we needed to do left. And as you can see, the door, that's how far it goes open, and it shuts really solid. Looks great on the machine. Really goes with the contour of the machine. And so yeah, open and close it, very simple. Just go ahead, pull this back, open it up, and go there. So I'll show it to you from the inside of the door here. As you can see, like we mentioned earlier, a 1-inch tubing and a steel skin door. So I'll show you from inside the machine here. So the way it latches, very nice, and it's solid. The best thing I love about these Rival doors is that it's got a cushion for your arm. So as you can see, the cushion is right here. That's very nice. A lot of doors don't come with this. That is a very nice touch, especially on the K&M Defender doors. So again, these are a set of Rival doors for the K&M Defender. These will work. This right here is a K&M HD5 2016-20. It'll work on the HD5s, HD8s, even the HD10s. So it'll work for all those models because they are all the same roll bar. So if you need these, you can go on offroadarmor.com and check them out. We appreciate your business. Thank you.